All right, outside of Roman and Goldberg and possibly Ronda, this was a mess show of SmackDown. Speaking of things known as WWE, I got a video on Shane McMahon coming out tomorrow. It's going to be talking about his release, the whole story of him getting heat and all that good stuff. But that video is coming out tomorrow, so be on the lookout for that. But like I said, man, outside of Roman and Goldberg and possibly again Ronda and Charlotte in the main segment tonight, I thought this was a meh episode coming off the heels of the Rumble. But let's not waste any time. Let's get to it. Paul Heyman comes out tonight, cuts a pretty good promo, explains and sums up everything that, you know, what happened with Roman was a mistake. But Roman gave me the acknowledgement. He gave me his hand, the family, the bloodline, and, you know, goes on to say that instead of me protecting Roman from Brock, I'm protecting Brock Lesnar from Roman Reigns. So Paul Heyman and Roman Reigns are back together again, which honestly is pretty cool to see. I like Roman and Brock. I mean, I like Roman and Paul Heyman. They fit well together. So I honestly am actually pretty glad that they are back together, even though Roman doesn't really need, you know, Paul Heyman, but it is what it is at the end of the day. But as Roman Reigns, you know, tells everybody to acknowledge me, out comes Goldberg. Goldberg's like, Roman, you're next. I acknowledge you. I acknowledge you, Roman, as my next victim. So it's settled. Roman Reigns and Goldberg, the match that was supposed to take place at WrestleMania 36, coincidentally, for the Universal title, but we all know what happened. Roman had to step away due to, we all know why. Now this match is taking place. So honestly, I know a lot of people are like, why is Goldberg getting another title shot? Me personally, it don't matter. We all know he's going to win. Roman's going to spear Goldberg into obliteration. Roman's going to retain the Universal title. He's going to fight Brock at Mania. So by the way, if you haven't seen my WrestleMania 38 match card predictions, go check that out as well. But after that segment, man, we got Ridge Holland versus Ricochet. And I mean, this is a meh match, you know, between Ricochet and Ridge Holland. Ricochet gets the win. And this leads to a match between Sheamus, Ridge Holland, and Cesaro and Ricochet. Now, Ricochet wins the singles match, but then he teams up with Cesaro. They get in this tag team match playa, which was meh. And Ridge Holland and Sheamus win. So you give Ricochet the win and then he loses. Like, I mean, granted, Cesaro got the pin, but still, like, really. Speaking of tag team matches playa, we got the SmackDown tag team champ. Well, not this wasn't a tag team match playa, but still, you got one half of the SmackDown tag team champions in the Uso. Jimmy Uso taking on Eric of one half of the Viking Raiders. Jimmy Uso gets the win. So, yeah. I'm kind of surprised they did this. You know, you're building up the Viking Raiders as this believable threat to the Usos. I thought that Eric low-key should have went over here, but hey, I mean, it was a solid match, so it was for what it was worth at the end of the day. Leah versus Natalya, I mean, this was average. I'm going to be real with you. It was kind of below average, if I'm being quite honest with you. Aaliyah does get the win by countout, so hey, she didn't get pinned, so yeah, but as far as, like, this match goes, this is like, you know what I'm saying? It's only a matter of time before, well, this feud ends, if you know what I'm saying. But we get Drew McIntyre back, man. He says he's glad to be back. You know, he's back with a vengeance. He's back for two men. He's back for Madcap Moss, and he's back for Baron Corbin. So now it has also been official. It seems like Drew McIntyre and Madcap Moss are going to face each other at the Elimination Chamber, which I low-key do not care about. I really don't care about it, to be quite honest with you. This just screams filler, if I'm being quite honest with you. But yeah, so we see all that happen. And we get a championship contenders match between the Intercontinental Champ Shinsuke Nakamura and Jinder Mahal. And Shinsuke Nakamura wins. He beats Jinder Mahal. So hey, at least Shinsuke gets his payback against Jinder after what he did to him at SummerSlam 2017. But Shinsuke wins in what was his first match back since he's been injured. So good for Shinsuke Nakamura. We get the New Day and Los Luthoris, man. This is actually probably the best match on the show, low-key. Big E is back on SmackDown now, most likely to help out with the Xavier Woods, who's recovered from injury. Get well soon, Xavier Woods, King Xavier Woods. But yeah, man, the New Day win. Like I said, pretty good tag team match. And yeah, and I man, like I said, it's pretty good. So yeah. But we get the main segment of the night, Charlotte and Ronda Rousey. Man, it's like, I really hope they're not trying to make Ronda a babyface. She does not need to be no babyface, people. Ronda should be a full-blown heel. She is at her best when she is a heel. When she plays this babyface role, it's not going to work because nobody really is fitting babyface Ronda Rousey. But what you need to know about the segment is that Ronda is going to fight Charlotte at Mania, and she attacks Sonya Deville, and that's the show. Like I said, this was a meh episode of SmackDown outside of Goldberg and Brock and possibly the main segment. Not Goldberg and Brock, Goldberg and Roman, my God. And possibly the main segment of the night. There's really nothing special about this episode of SmackDown coming off the heels of the Royal Rumble. So, yeah, this has been the Kid DC Wrestling.